Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Divedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking with you regarding the biography of a great philosopher, poet, dramatist, painter. You can use any word from him, friends. He was a polymath. He was a very talented man. His name is Rabindranath Tagore. So I will be discussing his biography with you, friends. So this is brought by me. If you want to follow me, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below. Also, this video is in English, friends. So if you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, its link is also given in the description box below. So moving forward, friends, I would like to tell you that please listen to this video just as a sort of story, information database. Don't, you don't think too much, listen to the notes. These notes don't refer too much to them. I've just taken them from convenience. There is nothing important given it, friends. Okay. So let's start. Just listen it as a story. This is only objective. Rabindranath Tagore was born on 7th of May 1861 in Calcutta. At that time, British India. Also, he died on 7th of August 1941, friends. Okay. Now, his place of death was also Calcutta. He was born at the Jora Sanko Mission. And he also died at the Jora Sanko Mission. Jora Sanko Mission was the ancestral home of the Tagore family. He had many children named as Renuka Tagore, Shamindranath Tagore, Meera Tagore, Rathindranath Tagore, and Madhuri Lata Tagore. And the name of his father was Debendranath Tagore, friends. Now, this Debendranath Tagore, this name is a very common name because Debendranath Tagore was very much actively associated with the Brahmo Samaj of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. So in the video of Brahmo Samaj and Raja Ram Mohan Roy video, I have already talked in little bit detail about Debendranath Dutt. Okay, friends, the mother's name of Rabindranath Tagore was Sharda Devi. Now see, friends, Rabindranath Tagore has composed some important information about him. He has composed the National Anthem of India, and he was the first non-European to get a Nobel Prize in literature. I have already told you he was associated with Brahmo Samaj. He was a poet, painter, he composed poems, he was a novelist, he wrote plays, dramas, he did almost everything, friends. Actually, he revived the whole sphere of Bengali art, and every field in Bengali art was touched by him, be it painting, music, poetry, anything, friends. Everything, he made an effect on it. Despite that, he was a polymath, friends. He was a big knowledgeable person. He had wide knowledge and learning. He read a lot of books. He read ancient philosophy. He read Western philosophy. Okay, friends. And because of his published works, he got the Nobel Prize. On that, I will come after some time, friends. He also met many big personalities, friends. When he met Albert Einstein, you very well know about Albert Einstein, friends. So Albert Einstein was the father of science. And Rabindranath Tagore at that point of time, he was actually the representative of spirituality. So when Albert Einstein met Rabindranath Tagore, it was said to be a fight, confrontation, a clash between science and spirituality. Likewise, Rabindranath Tagore met with many other people, friends, many other great personalities. About that, I will be talking later in this video. Also, in addition to composing the Janagan Man, which is the national anthem of India, friends, he has also composed Amar Sonar Bangla. This Amar Sonar Bangla is now the national anthem of Bangladesh. Also, friends, the national anthem of Sri Lanka is very much highly influenced through one composition of Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so as I've already told you, Rabindranath Tagore was born on 7th of May 1861 to father Debendranath Tagore and mother Sharda Devi in Jora Sanko Mansion. This Jora, J-O-R-A-S-A-N-K-O. So this Jora Sanko Mansion, friends, this was basically the ancestral home of the whole Tagore family. Now the point is that Debendranath Tagore and Sharda Devi has 13 children, friends. And in 13 children, Rabindranath Tagore was the youngest one. Despite having a very big family, he was raised, you know, his upbringing was through maids, the servants of the home, because he lost his mother at a very young age. And his father, Debendranath Tagore, he was associated in a lot of reform activities. So he was continuously traveling throughout India, friends, and even foreign. So he was not able to give much time to his son. Okay, but the point is that talent was in the blood of this Tagore family. So when he was a child, he started writing poems as the age of 8. And see, 8 is a very small age. We people, we actually didn't know properly to write at the age of 8. He wrote poems at the age of 8, friends. And by the age of 16, he started composing artworks, friends. And by the age of 16, he was writing under the name of Bhanu Simha. Okay. His short stories came out after some time. In 1877, he wrote the short story Bhikarini. In 1882, his poem collection Sandh Sangeet was published. This was a very famous collection. Even today, it is read, friends. Many of you would have already known about it, friends. Okay. Now, Rabindranath Tagore had a big love for learning, friends. He has read a lot of poets, including the poets of ancient India, like Kabir Das. Okay, friends, like Guru Nanak Das. You can say Kali Das. So, he was a, you know, in addition to being a poet, philosopher, this Rabindranath Tagore read a lot. So his learning enhanced. Also, friends, almost all of his siblings were very, very talented. They were very well educated. They were experts of their field. So Rabindranath Tagore learned a lot from his siblings also, from his brothers and sisters. He learned in the field of gymnastics, art, literature, mathematics, history, martial arts, you know, these type of subjects he used to learn, friends. And he was born in 1861. So by that time he was 12. In 1873, in 1873, he went on a tour of the country with his father, Debendranath Tagore. And while he was traveling to those places, he learned a lot. See, friends, traveling is something which opens up our mind, which opens up our horizon of thinking. You know, for example, you live in India. If you go to a foreign country, whenever you will go to a foreign country, suppose say you go to Malaysia, so you will meet their people, their way of learning, their way of etiquettes, their cultural traits. So everything you are going to know. So you will see that how they live, how they interact with each other, and how that is different from people interacting back home. So your thought process widens, your horizon, your thinking process widens. So all of these things happens, friends. Okay, so this was started happening with Rabindranath Tagore, and also during this tour with his father, he also went to Amritsar, friends. Now Amritsar is the center of Sikhism religion. So he also got to know a lot about Sikhism, and the mention of this religion is found in his works numerous times. Now the traditional education of Rabindranath Tagore is a bit hi-fi, friends. He started his education at a public school in Brighton, England. So you can see that he belonged to an affluent family, because today also people are even struggling to get a tourist visa to England, and at that point of time Rabindranath Tagore got his education in Brighton, England. Then because he was sent to England in 1878, because friends, his father wanted him to become a barrister. Okay, now the point is that Rabindranath Tagore had something else in his mind. He didn't like this traditional way of school learning, that is going to school, okay, learning from textbooks, teaching, you know, the professors are teaching you, you are writing it, you are making notes, then you are appearing in exams, then you are getting your numbers, then you are getting your degree. So this type of education, it did not appeal to Rabindranath Tagore. After passing out from this Brighton school, he went to University College in London, friends. But again in University College in London, he went there to study law. But he didn't like that traditional form of learning as usual. He also dropped that. But this doesn't mean that Rabindranath Tagore was not learning, friends. He was studying on his own. He read the works of Shakespeare. He read the works of many other Western philosophers and thinkers and big personalities of those times. He became a master of English literature, Irish literature, Scottish literature, friends. Okay, and when after learning all these things, when he came back to his mother country, India, friends, then he married Mrinalini Devi. Now, when he married Mrinalini Devi, you can understand she was only 10 years old. very young than Rabindranath Tagore. So you can see that even among the higher class of that time Indians, child marriage was common. Okay, friends. And Rabindranath Tagore belonged to a Brahmin family. Despite belonging to a Brahmin family, you know, this practice of childhood marriage was common at that point of time. Okay, friends. Now, we will talk about this Shantiniketan, friends. The point is this Shantiniketan, a huge stretch of huge piece chunk of land was bought by Debendranath Tagore. Now, Rabindranath Tagore got an idea that he should set up an ashram, a sort of prayer hall in this land. Okay, and whatever he was doing, friends, he shifted his way of teaching and education to this Shantiniketan in 1901. There he made a mandir, a prayer hall. Then also he made traditional sort of classes. For example, he planted a lot of trees there. The children used to sit beneath the trees and the teacher used to come and teach the children. So this was basically the Guru Shishya methodology of teaching, which was actually prevalent in India since ancient times. So you can see by this that the ideology of Rabindranath Tagore, that he believed in the ancient method of teaching and not in the modern traditional method of education. That is why Rabindranath Tagore has criticized the English system of education a lot. He repeatedly said that these English persons have imposed their system of education on the Indians. The ancient system of education of Indian is the best. He used to say this thing, friends. He liked the Guru Shishya style of method rather than going to school, fighting for marks and degrees. Also, friends, one thing in which Shantiniketan was not good for him was that his wife and two of his children died when he was in Shantiniketan, friends. And this was actually a bit shocking for Rabindranath Tagore. But the death of his wife and two children actually inspired him a lot to write more and more literature works, friends. This we will see afterwards. Now, time passed. This is somewhere around 1905, 1910. So whatever literature that Rabindranath Tagore has written, books, poets, philosophies, stories, novels, now people started reading them. Now when people started reading his literature, people started liking his philosophies, his ideologies, his way of writing. The popularity of Rabindranath Tagore increased and it reached to such proportions that in 1913 he was awarded with the Nobel Prize in Literature category, and he was the Asia's first Nobel laureate and the first non-European to get a Nobel Prize in the literature domain, friends. Okay, now when he became famous, you know, many people wanted to listen to him, many people wanted to talk to him, and these people included not only the students and the philosophers and teachers. They included the big and famous personalities of those time. As I have told you, that Rabindranath Tagore met Einstein at some point of his life, friends. So what happened that Rabindranath Tagore started his world tour. He also wanted to go from places to places and talk to people regarding his ideologies and convince them regarding his ideologies. And he was also able to do that. He went to United States, Malaysia, Rome, Japan, Singapore. And during these visits, he met very important people. He also met, in addition to Einstein, he met Benito Mussolini. Now, you must know this name. This Benito Mussolini is that ruler of Italy, friends, who subscribe to the ideology of fascism. In the Rome-Berlin Axis of World War II, you can see that Italy and Germany were allies. Hitler in Germany and Mussolini in Italy. So Rabindranath Tagore also met Mussolini and many other leaders all over the world, even in Southeast Asia. And those leaders were very much inspired and you can say impressed by his ideology. Okay, now ideology of Rabindranath Tagore when it comes to nationalism, a bit difficult. It is a bit tricky topic to understand. Rabindranath Tagore initially didn't like nationalism. Okay. He preferred his ideology over nationalism, but after some point of time, he realized that nationalism in India is growing strong and strong, and his ideology is coming weak in front of nationalism. Despite that, he, you know, more hated nationalism. But the point is that despite of the fact that he was not in support of nationalism, friends, he still supported the nationalist leaders of India. And you will see that he was given the knighthood by the British government, and when this Jallianwala Bagh massacre will take place, he will leave that knighthood and say to the British government that if you cannot protect my fellow countrymen, I don't need your knighthood. So actually, Rabindranath Tagore was not in favor of nationalism, but nationalistic leanings are there in his ideologies, thinkings, writings, friends. So this you can say about the personality of Rabindranath Tagore, friends. Okay, and see, friends, at that point of time, writing against Britishers openly was not something that Rabindranath Tagore could do. Rabindranath Tagore was not as oppressed as other Indians. He belonged to a well-to-do family. He had a good upbringing, you can see. He had a proper upbringing. So he was not so much oppressed by the British rule. Also, if he is going to write too much openly against the British rule, then obviously it will be banned by the Britishers. He will be charged with treason. So these things he clearly wanted to avoid. Also, and every philosopher used to avoid these things, friends, because this thing can stop everything what they are doing. Now we are going to talk about the literary works of Rabindranath Tagore. He wrote many novels, poems, short stories. Short stories was something which were very famous. He wrote Bhikarini at the age of very tender age of 16. Now, whatever he wrote, friends, he looked at whatever is going on in his surroundings and he wrote it. And he totally mentioned the social customs, the social evils that were present at that time in the Indian society. Those were reflected in his stories. He also wrote poems, friends. He also wrote novels. Now, novels was something, friends, which didn't made him popular. His novels were not very popular. The reason being, friends, that his way of explaining and going forward in the novels was very tricky. And you need a big amount of elite mind, a very philosopher type of mind in order to understand his novels. So that is why his novels didn't remain popular. You know, in order to make a novel popular, you have to make it easy. But Rabindranath Tagore's novels were very difficult to understand. It required philosophical insight, which anybody, you know, is not very much interested to put in. Also, Rabindranath Tagore's poems were very special. They drew inspiration from many poets like, as I told you, Guru Nanak Das, Ram Prasad Sen, Kabir Das. Okay, so a lot of things he did. Also, friends, he wrote a lot of dramas. When he was 20 years old, he wrote a drama named Valmiki Pratibha, and he even acted in it. So Rabindranath Tagore has also acted in a drama. So this was the level of talent, friends. He even wrote the drama and also acted in it. Also, friends, the biggest thing about Rabindranath Tagore is that he was also a painter. When he was 60 years old, friends, he started drawing paintings. And actually, his paintings were not bad. The exhibitions of his painting were displayed all over the world. This is the biggest thing. He took themes from artists, from places all over the world. But yes, his paintings were admired. And if you want to watch the paintings made by Rabindranath Tagore, friends, so you can go to the National Gallery of Modern Art in New Delhi, which have around 102 paintings of Tagore. Okay, friends, and as I've already told you, Tagore's political and nationalistic views are a bit tricky. Initially, he was against nationalism. After that, you know, he never openly supported nationalism, but yes, he supported India's nationalist leaders. He actually opposed and spoke against the colonialistic and imperialistic policies of the British government. He said that British government is trying to exploit the people of India. Also, he openly renounced his knighthood when this Jallianwala Bagh tragedy took place. So, sort of nationalist feelings were also there in him, friends. Okay, a lot of TV serials, movies and depictions, adaptations of his works have been done by many different artists. Okay, in the last years of his life, friends, Rabindranath Tagore was in a lot of pain. He remained ill for many years, you know, say more than 3 years. And finally, he died on 7th of August 1941. It's the same Jora Sangh Commission in which he was born, friends. Okay, so this you can see, friends, he died in Jora Sangh Commission. He was also born in Jora Sangh Commission on 7th of May 1861. He died on 7th of August 1941. So this was all the important information about Rabindranath Tagore, friends. Okay, his legacy is found in almost complete culture of India, especially in the Bengali culture. Many statues of Rabindranath Tagore has been, you can say, established all over the country. There are many statues, there are many roads named after him, friends. Also, there are complete 5 museums dedicated to him, 3 of which of them are in India and 2 in Bangladesh. So I hope this video about Rabindranath Tagore was helpful for you. If it was really helpful for you, friends, kindly subscribe to my channel, like this video. Please share this video with more and more of your friends. And if you have any issue, you can tell me in the comment section below. So thank you, friends. Goodbye. Take care.